Sans family, Chevalier.
I was her father's friend. Annoying to our business associations. Practically the guardian of our fortune. I regard myself as in loco parentis, as it were.
Such loyalty is rare in these degenerate times. Bring her in immediately. Good news, Chevalier.
They have caught Lucien Cartier.
No, but Mademoiselle de Brissaille is safe. She is outside now, asking for a personal interview with me.
Owing to what has transpired between us, you have no objection to my being present at this interview?
Naturally.
My dear Cecile, heaven be praised. I've been overcome with anxiety about you.
I hardly expected to meet the Chevalier del Gardo here.
Perhaps you would prefer to speak to Monsieur Gouffet alone.
What I have to say is as much for your ears as Monsieur Gouffet's. I bring you a message from Lucien Cartier.
You know where that arch criminal is hiding?
Lucien is no criminal.
It is an offense to withhold information from the police. Is that not so, Monsieur Gouffet?
That is so.
If he were guilty, yes. You, Monsieur Gouffet, wish to arrest the guilty party, don't you?
Of course, mademoiselle.
The police have all the evidence they need, mademoiselle.
But it's only circumstantial. I'm here to offer you definite proof.
But how is that possible?
You've heard of Professor Leblanc, who has devoted his life to experimenting with electricity.
Oh, yes, we've heard of him. They call him the Mad Professor.
He's the most brilliant scientist of the day.
Sane or mad, I fail to see how the professor can help us.
If you and the Chevalier will attend his laboratory at 8 o'clock tonight, I guarantee that Lucien Cartier will be there. The professor will then perform an electrical test, whereby the identity of the wolf will be known for good and all.
An electrical test? Do you think the police will have any truck with all this mumbo-jumbo?
Monsieur Gouffet, I beg you to do as I ask.
But, mademoiselle, it's contrary to all precedent.
But what have you got to lose? Lucien Cartier will be there. If you are not satisfied with the result of the test, you can arrest him.
My dear child, you don't know what you're saying. You're overwrought.
Oh, don't touch me. Monsieur Gouffet, I entreat you. You know the agony I've been through. First my father murdered, then my lover accused. Surely, surely it's not too much to ask. Especially when I tell you that it is upon my poor father's body the test will be carried out.
What?
Mademoiselle.
He knew who killed him. I saw it in his face. And the professor's discovery will tell us all he knew.
This is incredible.
But surely if I'm prepared to permit this, in a last desperate attempt to fix the guilt of these awful crimes, you can support me. If you refuse me, I'll despair of justice. Of God himself.
My poor child, it shall be as you say.
Oh, bless you for your kindness.
But I warn you, I can hold out no hope of Lucien Cartier's escaping arrest.
I have faith in him. I'm prepared to stand by it.
Then you will meet us at the professor's house at 8 o'clock, Chevalier?
I shall be there, monsieur. Oh, yes. I shall be there. Oh, no, my friend de Brisson. No voice from the dead. You and I have settled our account.
Arrived yet, Louis?
Not yet, monsieur.
We're a little early, Lucien. Yes. We can wait.
Got him, all right.
Oh, Lucien, it's horrible.
Come away, darling. I should have stayed with him to guard him.
But what's going to happen?
We're powerless without him.
Gouffer and the police will be here in a few minutes.
And Delgado.
Oh, he won't dare appear.
Yes, he will, to enjoy his triumph. But we've got to beat him. Quick, monsieur, look at this. This after he was stabbed.
Lucien, if there's no experiment, they'll arrest you.
But there shall be.
But who can do it?
I will. I can do it. I know I can.
But it's impossible. You don't understand electricity.
There's no time for questions. You must trust me and do exactly as I tell you.
Right.
Go into the hall. Wait for Gouffet and Delgado. Tell them nothing, but keep them there until I call you.
I understand.
And whatever happens, don't bring them in here till I'm ready. Help me with Monsieur de Besson's body.
Ah, Monsieur Gouffer, punctual as ever. And ready for the arrest, too, I see.
In a few moments now, this whole mystery will be solved.
And without the aid of mad scientists, I trust.
Where is Lucien Cartier?
He will be here in a minute.
I kept my side of the bargain, Mademoiselle de Brisson. I now expect you to keep yours.
And our host, the mad professor?
He is with Lucien.
As they won't come to us, we'd better go to them. Monsieur Gouffer, please order your gendarme to search the house.
But you promised to wait.
This is mere subterfuge.
That is where you're wrong, Chevalier. Would you mind stepping in here?
Where's the professor?
Here, Monsieur Gouffer.
That is Monsieur de Brisson.
How do you know that?
Mademoiselle Cecile so informed us.
You mean the professor is dead?
I do. A few minutes before you arrived, he was struck down and murdered by the wolf.
Not to be wondered at, considering the wolf is present in the house.
Without the professor, we can do nothing.
I work with the professor on his research, and I know sufficient to take his place.
Oh, enough of this mockery. Here is the murderer. I order you, Monsieur Gouffer, to arrest him.
But, Monsieur Gouffer, you promised.
But I protest.
You forced me to point out, Chevalier, that I am in charge here.
This time, the wolf didn't strike with his usual accuracy. Professor LeBlanc lived long enough after his murderer's departure to write this. The name of the wolf is L-U-C. And then life departed from him and his hand stayed still.
Perhaps I can complete the sentence. Was known as Lucien Cartier.
Silence, please, Chevalier. Continue, Monsieur Cartier.
As you know, the professor has been experimenting for some time on the power of electricity to revivify the muscles of one recently dead, so that they complete the action ordered by the brain at the time of death. I have therefore placed the professor's body on this table and connected it with wires to the apparatus you see before you. When I switch on the electricity, if the professor's theory is correct, that dead hand will come to life and complete the writing on that piece of paper, disclosing the identity of his murderer, the wolf. And let me warn you that on no account to touch the sheet, as it will be charged with such a current of electricity as would kill instantaneously. Are you ready? Now. Mm-hmm.